Good afternoon, friends. Let me proceed further, and I'll be showcasing to you one of the very good report, and I really love this report. And again, it's a part of my daily responsibility that yes, I should read at least one of the report that is presented on any randomly. I pick up a topic and I start taking care of it. Now, here you will see that I was working on a topic. Especially on cross-country or multicultural consumption of beer. And then I came, while searching or Googling around, I just came upon, bumped into this particular website, which was euromonitor.com. There, I had to go ahead and check out as to what are the points that they're covering and everything. Now, first and foremost, I would like to tell you is that the moment I entered this particular website, the first thing I could see is capture is US dollars 990. Now, even if you go ahead, convert it into INR, you see that $990, US dollars, whether it has been increased right now, however, roughly comes about to be 75,598.88 rupees. Can you believe that? This is the cost of the report. And I got a shock, and I'm going to share my experience also. I had to go ahead, contact the person at the main headquarter, because it was not the Indian one that I was checking out, it was the international one. I had to write a mail to them saying that I'm planning to see the contents of it. Is it possible that I can get a copy of something, a report which is an old one? Can you showcase it to me? Then they diverted my communication to them, to the company based in India, and that is from Pune. Now, in Pune, this young lady, she called me up and she said that I think you wanted to see, ma'am, the cost of that. At that time, it was not for this one, that was pertaining to a different report of mine. And I asked her, so what is the cost? Then she said it would be for 35,000 and some change. I said, 35,000 for a simple report? She said, ma'am, it's not a very simple report. If you will see the content of it, I said, I haven't seen the sample, does not give me the leverage to see the entire. Then she said, okay, what I'll do, I'll take the approval from my supervisor and I'll send you a sample copy of it. And she did. And within half an hour or 45 minutes, I received the mail. And trust me, the moment I opened the content, the PDF thing, I was amazed to see the way they had covered the entire information. Now, here you will see that on the left-hand side, it gives you executive summary. You can just click on it. You will be given and to see what exactly, and just have a look at the coloring part of it and how well they have maintained this part of it. I'll be discussing later on. Then I was entrusted with samples. Reason, I said, okay, I'm getting this particular report. Let me go ahead. And before I can show it to you, can you see on the right-hand side what they are showcasing? This is exclusively for the beer in Australia. However, it's not just limited to Australia. We all know that. Now, here, have a look what all countries they are covered under this one. The report that you get, the complete report, contains not only their analysis and the complete report, however, it even contains the data. So I was looking beer in Algeria, beer in Argentina, beer in Austria, Azerbaijan, then Belarus, Belgium, Bolivia, Bosnia, then you have got Brazil, Bulgaria, Cameroon, then Canada, Chile, China, Colombia, and the list goes. So you can see how many countries they have covered in their report. And let me search my mailbox if I have got, though it's a copyright issue and I have to take the, this is present on the public domain, so I'm not so much worried about it. However, the report that they have sent, it was a working report of theirs, and I need to take their approval before I can showcase to you the complete data. Now, the moment you click on beer market sample, and let me showcase to you the entire report. So here they says passport. Now the report that they are giving it to you does not, the title does not give. Now have a look at each and everything and then go forward in your own style of writing a report. The color combinations, number one, number two, the title presentation, then comes the subtitle, year and your name or the company's or institute's name, whatever. And then they're managing it, everything out here. And the copyright issue is also there that I haven't yet showcased to you. List of contents, so you can have a look. Headlines, trends, production, imports, exports, competitive landscape, prospects, category, background, summary. In some, you will be seeing in the form of summary. In some reports, it would be abstract. And in other cases of report writing, you will see as the executive summary also they have given. So you can choose as per your writing style. Then the category data, along with the page numbers that they have mentioned out here. Then you can see the entire title that they have given to various things that they are going to cover in this particular report, I would say, including taxation, duty levies, and then etc. etc. So you can have a look and see how they have covered the topics, you know. And once you enter into the report also, you need to check out with the color combinations, the pattern in which it is written, the background of it, each and everything matters to us a lot. Now, this is how a professional company is going to publish their, I would say, the report that you have got out here. Now, similarly, I'm just going to showcase to you the sample of the data collection. So you can see that it is the region. Let me go to the first one and make it. So they have got the cover sheet in the data, even if you are sharing it. You know, remember that this is one of the ways in which you can catch the person, you know, from using your data. Because here, once you are submitting it, you're taking care of it, your Excel sheet is already copyrighted. And during my 5-day training with Vipo, which is Vipo is a company located, which is the headquarters for the intellectual property rights. And I was doing this particular course from Indian Institute of International Laws. And under that, they had the one PG diploma course on, copyrights and intellectual property. Now, I was enrolled myself, and thanks to Nachiappan sir, who was the chairman of that, but and president of that particular institute, which is located right opposite to the Supreme Court of India. And you will see, even those individuals came from Switzerland, that is Geneva, and they gave us that training, you know, how to understand how the data can be shared with others, and you can keep a copyright for yourself. And in those 5 days, it was hands-on experience for us, and I can never forget, because there was this judge who had come, the lady judge, I would say, who visited India, from Australia, and an amazing person. I can never forget her in my life, because she was sitting next to me, and the kind of observations, you know, I could understand why that those kind of observations are coming in and why she wanted, because she was the judge for the copyrights and intellectual property for Australia. So now, both of us were interacting with each other, and we came to know that, yes, this is how the things, and, for her being a judge, she could not just take it away for granted, that whatever. So she was asking again and again, subtle questions, and we came to know about those things from the team which had come to India from Geneva. Now, here you will see that even when you are sharing your data, trust me, the moment you have presented it in a professional manner like this, you have already copyrighted it. And I'll show you, and it is your intellectual property. Nobody can go ahead and say that, okay, I'm just copied it and I'm using it. They need to take your approval. They need to submit it into writing. Please do not go with the verbal commitments. Verbal commitments, more than verbal commitments, I would say, go in black and white. Ask them to send you any kind of a communication which is available, and it is easier for them. However, it has to come in, and you have to record it also side by side. And here, when I'm talking about the Euro monitor, coming back to this particular report, you will see that it is not just the kind. Now, have a look at what all things they have mentioned. Number one, categories, whatever it is, geographies, because it's a, I should say they covered it for the entire majority of the countries across the globe. So here it is a sample copy. Therefore, it's just been showcased as Venezuela. Otherwise, you can see, and then measures. Have a look at the details that they have given you. Market sizes, unit prices, company shares, NBO, then global brand name, local brand name, global brand name, channel, exports by country, by value, volume, value, then volume, then products by ingredient, by actuals, trade statistics, volume-wise pricing, definitions. You see, they are going to give you each and everything. Dare anyone uses this data without taking the approval from them? Even me, who is shocking. Now, here you can have a look at it. This is what I call it as copyright or intellectual property right declaration for your own thing. Once this is there, nobody can. And here it is mentioned very clearly. For more information, contact Euromonitor International, which I did it. Because I wanted to know more information, logo, name of the company, copyright, this is what we call it a declaration, and database rights are with the Euromonitor International. This is for an organization and how they are using those copyrights and the intellectual property rights. When I'll come back to my videos in the playlist of the copyright, I'll be showcasing to you as to how, as an academician, you can go and you can utilize it. You know, you cannot just simply say that, okay, I'm not going to do anything. This is there. So fine, you have deposited it. However, mention this. This document is strictly copyright. Reproduction or distribution in any form whatsoever without express written permission. This is what I was telling you. No verbal commitments. It has to come to you in the written format from Euromonitor International Limited is prohibited. So you see, once you give this kind of a declarations, which you have, you need to utilize it and take care. Then you have got this cover sheet. This is called as the cover sheet of your data. And you're supposed to make this one in the first go. Then whatever your variables are, let's say for market sizes, so region. So here, you know, if I just scroll down out here, they've just limited themselves for Latin America in this sample copy. If you purchase it, you'll be seeing that you have got the regions across the world. Then similarly for the country, industry, you know, there are different categories, how they have specified it. Then the category beer, then, you know, they have other varieties also, which they have not. Then subcategory, lowest level, data type, then unit, current constant, and all these things are there. Then unit prices, company shares, whatever they have defined, you know, they are going to go ahead and, you know, present it out in this sample copy. I mean, even if you get the original copy also, and the way they use it is tremendous. And for one particular topic, I had to purchase it nearly for 28,000. And I could see why this report is so important for me. Now, here you can have a look at the stores and the countries, the industries which are available. And here they have mentioned it very clearly, view all 210 countries. So it is not just few industries that you are visible right now. They are covering around 210 countries also. Solutions are there. You can even ask them to help you out or on a particular topic if you're interested and if you are ready to pay that amount, you can go ahead and you can take care of it. So they have their own blog careers. Anyway, I'm not so much interested right now. And about us. So you can read about them. You can click on these things also and in order to get more information. So now you must have understood as to why I love Euromonitor International reports. Now this is a very simple one. There are other reports also which are you know, really fascinate me, and I really love them, and I have kept it in my desktop also. I'll show you if time permits me after covering up some topics here. So I'm going to end with this particular video of mine, and let me catch up with yet another topic. Till then, thank you and bye.